What if a single invention could lower the price of housing, reimagine transportation, and reduce our dependency on natural resources? What if that very thing had already been invented? Hi everyone, Ken here. Today we are re-examining the idea of the geodesic dome house and the forgotten innovations of Buckminster Fuller. Hit that subscribe button and let's explore this house. The evolution of the dome home owes much of its remarkable journey to the inventive spirit of Buckminster Fuller, an architect, thinker, and futurist who believed that human ingenuity could solve global challenges if only we learned how to do more with less. Fuller's entire career was focused on devising better ways to house, transport, and connect people while conserving energy and resources. Over time, he came to be known for several visionary projects, including the Dymaxion house, Dymaxion car, Dymaxion map, and one of his most enduring legacies, the geodesic dome. His love for experimentation extended to larger ideas like tensegrity, a structural principle relying on tension and compression, and even inspired a branch of carbon molecules called fullerenes, named for their resemblance to his geodesic designs. Although some of his creations never reached mass production, Fuller's ideas proved both fascinating and influential, constantly nudging us towards a more innovative way of building our world. Fuller's fascination with housing began in the late 1920s when he set out to create a dwelling that could be easily shipped and assembled anywhere. He wanted to address what he viewed as major problems in conventional home design: excessive weight, inefficient use of materials, and the lack of easy relocation options. He disliked the notion that a family needing to move across the country should have to leave behind their entire dwelling. His solution to that problem was a lightweight structure packaged like a product, with components that could be easily shipped and assembled, sparing people from starting over every time life led them somewhere new. This dream ultimately became known as the Dymaxion house, a name derived from three words Fuller used often: dynamic, maximum, and tension. At different points in his life, Fuller tried various versions of the Dymaxion house, all with the same underlying goal: make it portable, make it durable, and make it as efficient as possible. In several prototypes, he proposed suspending the house from a central mast, not unlike the way the hub of a bicycle wheel supports the rim with spokes. By using cables and lightweight materials such as aluminum alloys, he kept the overall weight surprisingly low. Many accounts say the Dymaxion house weighed roughly 3,000 pounds, lighter than a typical car today. He wanted people to see houses as a service rather than a permanent fixture. If you moved, you'd take your house right along with you, presumably by disassembling and loading it into a shipping tube. One of Fuller's post-war prototypes, sometimes referred to as the Wichita House, was meant to be mass-produced in an aircraft factory used during World War II. Much like an airplane fuselage, the home shell would be crafted from aluminum, taking advantage of the enormous surplus of metal and skilled workers in the aircraft industry once the war had ended. Orders for the house came in, some say thousands, but Fuller was never fully satisfied with his design. Perfectionist to the core, he kept postponing production, wanting to iron out every flaw. Despite never truly finding its way into every neighborhood, the Dymaxion house remains a captivating study in how we might lighten our footprint while still retaining comfort and style. The round design was especially striking to visitors who stepped inside the prototypes. The interior offered a large wraparound window and optional built-in features like rotating closets, revolving shelves, and a fogger shower designed to use mere droplets of water. Fuller even proposed a packaging toilet that would seal and store waste for future composting. Although the toilet never came to fruition, these ideas showed how seriously he took resource conservation, hoping to eliminate unnecessary water use and lighten the burdens typically placed on a community's plumbing infrastructure. While developing ideas for a new type of home, Fuller also ventured into transportation with a whimsical yet serious attempt at rethinking cars. He built something known as the Dymaxion car, or ground taxiing phase of future vehicle he imagined could someday transition seamlessly between land, water, and air. Long before the era of sleek electric cars and aerodynamic SUVs, Fuller was shaping a bullet-like design for better fuel efficiency and minimal drag. The Dymaxion car featured three wheels, a rear-mounted engine, and steering via its single rear wheel that could pivot dramatically, supposedly letting it execute incredibly tight turns. This was all in the 1930s, when such ideas were revolutionary. Unfortunately, a tragic crash involving a prototype, combined with the unorthodox design, sidelined any hope of mass adoption. Fuller kept insisting the car wasn't supposed to be a conventional sedan, but rather a test platform for a flying machine that happened to roll on the ground. Although the Dymaxion car ultimately faded into obscurity, its streamlined shape and futuristic spirit foreshadowed a new wave of aerodynamic automobiles that would eventually emerge decades later. Fuller's ideas weren't limited to cars and houses. He also believed that how we visualize the world affects how we think about it. This conviction led him to create the Dymaxion map, a global map projection he hoped would help people see the continents as one large island surrounded by one continuous ocean rather than chopped and stretched by common rectangular projections. By projecting the globe onto a series of triangles that could be folded and unfolded, he worked to reduce distortions in size and shape. With the Dymaxion map, he wanted to free viewers from the usual north-is-up outlook. He argued there was no cosmic rule making the northern hemisphere top dog on the map. In his view, we're all afloat on quote-unquote spaceship Earth, so no single part ought to be front and center by default. This was typical of Fuller, always questioning assumptions, always nudging people to see things in a fresh way. By far, however, his most iconic contribution is the geodesic dome. Popularly linked to Fuller, though the earliest concept was pioneered by others decades before, this dome design arranges triangles in such a way that stresses are distributed evenly throughout the structure. In practice, it's a marvel. It can be unbelievably lightweight while covering vast areas with minimal materials. For any set diameter, the geodesic dome encloses the greatest amount of space with the least surface area. This efficiency was nearly irresistible to industries in need of large covered areas. This includes radar stations, exhibition halls, and storage facilities, and even futuristic houses. Fuller's name became so synonymous with geodesic domes that people around the globe started calling him the Dome Man. Everyone from the military to environmental activists tried adapting the structure because it could be assembled quickly and endure substantial wind or snow loads without collapsing. Geodesic dome houses, sometimes called dome homes, pop up in unexpected places. In some climates, they function wonderfully by distributing rain and wind pressure. In others, owners have discovered the geometry can make them tricky to wire, insulate, or partition with standard building materials. Nonetheless, the practical benefits, combined with their dramatic visual impact, have attracted many people willing to put in some extra work to adapt them for modern living. These homes look futuristic even decades after the concept was popularized, a testament to Fuller's ahead of its time thinking. He was convinced the dome was the perfect marriage of geometry and functionality, letting owners maximize internal space and minimize material use. Fuller's endless curiosity about structure didn't stop at domes. He also toyed with tensegrity, a term he coined by blending tension and integrity. Tensegrity structures combine rigid struts under compression with flexible cables under tension to create stable, self-supporting frameworks. They can look like floating sculptures of rods and cables, able to stand with an almost magical lightness. This same principle shows up in nature. Our own bodies exhibit tensegrity in the way bones and muscles interact, so Fuller recognized that the principle could translate into architecture and product design. Although tensegrity has remained somewhat specialized, it has had noticeable ripples in engineering, robotics, and contemporary art. Every time you see those carefully balanced wire and rod sculptures, you're seeing the legacy of Fuller's passion for structural innovation. Buckminster Fuller's grand sense of possibility even stretched into the molecular realm. Scientists discovered a particle arrangement of carbon atoms shaped somewhat like a geodesic sphere. Because of its close resemblance to Fuller's domes, these molecules were named fullerenes. The most famous example, Buckminster Fullerene C60, is composed of 60 carbon atoms arranged like a soccer ball, pentagons and hexagons forming a resilient hollow sphere. It's a lovely echo of Fuller's geometry, that at a scale invisible to the naked eye, scientists stumble upon a shape that tied back to an architect's quest for better, lighter, and stronger structures. Taken as a whole, Fuller's work was always driven by his faith that humanity could solve pressing problems by carefully examining design, geometry, and efficiency. His motto of ephemeralization, which is doing more with less, is still relevant in an age of environmental concerns and dwindling resources. Whether it's about turning the roof of a dome into a natural ventilation system or finding new ways to recycle water, his abiding mission was to free people from unnecessary constraints so they could focus on creativity and collaboration. In his view, better design was not just about convenience or aesthetics, it was the key to ensuring that spaceship Earth could sustain all of its passengers. Although many of Fuller's visions never entered everyday use, after all, most of us don't live in a Dymaxion house or glide around in three-wheeled aerodynamic cars, his legacy still endures in subtle and surprising ways. Architects frequently draw on the geodesic dome for stadium roofs and ecotourism cabins. Tensegrity remains a source of fascination for structural engineers designing lightweight footbridges or next-generation robots. Fullerenes have opened new frontiers in chemistry, nanotechnology, and material science. And the Dymaxion map, though not a standard classroom staple, encourages people to see the world as a continuous, interconnected whole. Fuller himself often spoke of the need to consider the Earth as a unified system, an idea that has grown more popular as environmental awareness increases. He believed in synergy, the principle that the total can be greater than the sum of its parts, and he poured his energy into exploring how synergy might lead to solutions never before imagined. His was a broad optimism. As long as we kept our minds open, shared knowledge widely, and questioned default assumptions, we might find new patterns that would change everything for the better. For those who have stepped inside a geodesic dome or visited the Dymaxion House exhibit at the Henry Ford Museum, the sense of stepping into Fuller's imagination can be exhilarating. There is a spark of what if in his inventions, a notion that the ways we live, travel, and think need not be restricted by tradition. He never shied away from radical rethinks, unusual shapes, unconventional materials, or big leaps in engineering. Even when his dreams didn't quite take hold in the mainstream, they stimulated generations of designers, inventors, and students who felt the pull of his visionary style. What began as a quest to house people better, faster, and more affordably ultimately became a wide-ranging pursuit of harmony between human innovation and the planet's limited resources. And that is the real heart of the Dome Home's evolution. It's about believing that with careful thought, experimentation, and a willingness to break free of old habits, we can craft living environments that lighten our load on nature. Fuller taught us that daring to challenge assumptions might be our best hope for a truly sustainable world, and in that sense, the Dome Home is more than just a piece of architecture. It's an invitation to dream bigger, to trust in our capacity to innovate, and to remember that perhaps the greatest structure we inhabit is the one we all share, the incredible world beneath our common sky. And with that, I'll turn it over to you. Let me know your thoughts on everything from the Dymaxion movement to dome houses. Do you think these nearly 100-year-old ideas are worth a second look? Let me know down below in the comments section. And while you're there, make sure you're subscribed so you never miss an exciting episode of This House.